An oligopoly is an industry characterized by few dominant firms. Oligopoly is said to prevail when there are few firms in the market producing or selling a product. Oligopoly is also referred to as competition among the few. A special case of oligopoly is duopoly, where two firms are competing with each other. Under oligopoly, each firm has enough market power to prevent itself from being a price taker, but each firm is facing inter-firm rivalry, which is preventing it to consider the market demand curve as its own demand curve. Competition among oligopolist firm is so severe, four economists call it as a cutthroat competition. All the firms under oligopoly industry are behaving strategically. But when firms are behaving strategically, the oligopolist firm faces a basis dilemma, that is, to cooperate with other firms or to compete with other firms. When an oligopolistic firm is cooperating with other firms, it gives rise to cooperative solutions. But if firms compete with each other, it gives rise to non-cooperative equilibrium. The cooperative solution. If the firm is an industry cooperating among themselves to produce the monopoly output, then they can maximize their joint profits. The cooperation among firms may be either tacit or formal. A formal cooperation among firms is one when all the firms under oligopolistic industry, after consultation and discussion, agree to observe certain rules of conduct with respect to price, output, etc. This formal cooperation is also known as collusive oligopoly. On the other hand, the tacit cooperation among firms occurs when all the firms under oligopolistic industry, without consultation and discussion, have developed some understanding between them and pursue a uniform policy with regards to price, output, etc. So, if the firms tacitly or formally cooperate, then will reach to a cooperative solution. Second, the non-cooperative equilibrium or Nash equilibrium. The non-cooperative equilibrium is an equilibrium that is reached by firms. They proceed by calculating only their own gains without cooperating with others. It is called non-cooperative equilibrium or a Nash equilibrium. Nash equilibrium, each firm is doing the best it can given what competitors are doing, and firms proceed by calculating only their own gains without cooperating with others. The concept of Nash equilibrium was first explained by mathematician John Nash in 1951 and received the Nobel Prize in Economics for his work. Nash equilibrium in each firm's best strategy is to maintain its present behavior given the present behavior of the other firms. The concept of Nash equilibrium is widely used in game theory. After studying this module, you shall be able to know the concept of oligopoly, understand Nash equilibrium, know the concept of games, know how the concept of game theory can be applied to microeconomics. Let us begin with oligopoly as a game. In 1994, mathematician John von Neumann and economist Oscar Morgenstern published a work in which they analyzed a set of problems or games in which two or more people pursue their own interests and in which one of them can dictate the outcome. In an oligopolistic market, each individual firm is faced with a problem of choosing rational course of action from many possible actions while keeping in view the possible reactions of his rivals whose counter moves would affect him. Game theory analyzes the oligopolistic behavior as a series of strategic moves and reactive counter moves among rival firms. A strategy is a course of action which a player in a game will choose during the play of the game. Players are choosing strategies without knowing with certainty what strategy its rival is going to play. Here it is assumed that firms are anticipating rival reactions. Each player's aim is to maximize their own payoff by choosing specific actions, but the actual outcome also depends upon what other players are doing. The payoff matrix shows the profit of each player given its decision and the decision of its competitors. Types of games. In normal or strategic form games, players are moving moves simultaneously, whereas in extensive form games, players are moving moves in some order over time. One shot game is a game that is played only once, and super game that is repeated an infinite number of times. Let us talk about game theory in oligopoly. When game theory is applied to oligopoly, the players are firms. Their game is played in a market. Their strategies are their price and output decisions, and their payoffs are profits. Let us explain the concept of equilibrium with the help of an example. We are taking the case of two firms who are producing a homogeneous product, and each firm has two possible strategies, that is, each firm can produce an output equal to one half of the monopoly output, the passive strategy, and jointly sharing the monopoly profit. Each firm can produce an output equal to two-thirds of the monopoly output, the aggressive strategy. The strategic form of the game can be written as players. There are two players, firm A and firm B. Game. Both and B is producing output in the market. Strategy. Each firm can produce an output equal to either one half of the monopoly output or two-thirds of the monopoly output. Payoff matrix. Profit of each firm given its decision of its competitors. The payoff matrix is given in table. In table, the figure in the four boxes show the profit of firm A and firm B. Let us explain these payoffs. The upper left hand corner of the payoff matrix tells us that if both firms are producing one half of the monopoly output, both firms would make a profit of rupees 20 each. The upper right hand corner tells us that if firm B produces one half of monopoly output and firm A produces two-thirds of monopoly output, firm B would make a profit of rupees 15 and firm A rupees 22. The lower left hand corner tells us that if firm B produces two-thirds of monopoly output and firm A produces one-half of monopoly output, firm B would make a profit of rupees 22 and firm A rupees 15. The lower right hand corner tells us that if firm B produces two-thirds of monopoly output and firm A also choose to produce two-thirds of monopoly output, both would make a profit of rupees 17 each. Now the question is what the two firms would do to, that is, to cooperate with each other or compete with each other. The possible solution could be, first, the passive or cooperative solution. If both firms cooperate with each other, that is, both are producing one half of the monopoly output, then they both are getting a profit of rupees
20 each. Under cooperative solution, both are jointly producing the monopoly output and sharing profit equally among them. The cooperative solution is achieved by playing strategy. One half monopoly output, one half monopoly output. Second, the aggressive non-cooperative or Nash equilibrium. Nash equilibrium is the equilibrium where each firm is doing the best it can given what its competitors are doing, and each firm proceed by calculating only their own gains without cooperating with others. Definition: a strategy S star I is a best response to a strategy vector S star minus I of the other player if pi I function of S star I comma S star minus I is greater than or equal to pi I is a function of S I comma S star minus I for all S I. Here S star I is a dominant strategy in the sense that it is a best strategy to play provided the other players do in fact play the strategy combinations S star minus I. There must be a condition to ensure that player I is correct in his inference that the other players are correct in their inferences. This gives us the following definition. The strategy vector S star is equal to S star 1 comma S star 2 so on till S star n is a Nash equilibrium if pi I is a function of S star I comma S star minus I is greater than or equal to pi I is a function of S I comma S star minus I for all S I and all I. There is one Nash equilibrium in table 1. The best decision for each firm is to produce 2/3 of the monopoly output where each firm is earning a profit of Rs. 17. Here, neither firm has an incentive to depart from this position except through cooperation with the other firm. In any other cell, each firm has incentive to change its output given the output of the other firm. In table 1, suppose if firm A chooses to produce one half of the monopoly output, then firm B would choose to produce 2/3 of the monopoly output. This is so because the profit earned by firm B when producing 2/3 of the monopoly output is Rs. 22, which is more than Rs. 20, that is when producing one half of the monopoly output. But if firm A choose to produce 2/3 of the monopoly output, then firm B would also choose to produce 2/3 of the monopoly output as it is giving a profit of Rs. 17, which is more than Rs. 15. When he is producing one half of the monopoly output. So there is one Nash equilibrium when both firms are producing 2/3 of the monopoly output. Neither firm has an incentive to depart from this position. Nash equilibrium. Both firms are producing 2/3 of the monopoly output and earning a profit of Rs. 17 each. 3. Strategic behavior. When each firm is behaving strategically, that is choosing its optimal strategy, taking into account what the other firms may do, we attain Nash equilibrium. What would firm A would do if it knows what firm B is doing? Firm B can do two things. That is, either he can produce one half of the monopoly output or two-thirds of the monopoly output. First, suppose firm B is producing one half of the monopoly output, then what would be the best decision for firm A? When firm B is producing one half of the monopoly output and firm A also chooses the same, then firm A will get a profit of rupees 20. But if firm A chooses to produce two-thirds of the monopoly output, then firm A will get a profit of rupees 22. Secondly, suppose firm B is producing two-thirds of the monopoly output and firm A also chooses the same, then firm A will get a profit of rupees 17. But if firm A chooses to produce one half of the monopoly output, then firm A will get a profit of rupees 15. In either case, the best strategy for firm A is to produce two-thirds of the monopoly output. Aggressive behavior is the dominant strategy. A dominant strategy is a strategy that is best no matter what the rival does. In this game, both firms have a dominant strategy, which is to produce two-thirds of the monopoly output. Firm B will reason in the same way. So, as a result, both end up by jointly producing 1/3 times the monopoly output and earning a profit of rupees 17. 4. Breakdown of cooperation. Nash equilibrium is attained when firms are behaving strategically, but then why tacit cooperation tends to break down? Suppose both firms are cooperating with each other and producing one half of the monopoly output and earning a profit of rupees 20 each. If firm A cheats by increasing its output, its profit will increase, but firm B's profit will decline. This behavior of firm A drives down the price in industry, so firm B earns less from its unchanged output. This cheating by firm A causes a fall in the joint profits by taking firms away from the joint maximizing monopoly output. So firm B's profit would fall by more than the rise in the firm A's profit. The similar consideration also applies to firm B. So both firms A and B have an incentive to depart from the joint profit maximizing level of output. So when either firm does depart from the joint maximizing output, the other has an incentive to do so as well. When each follows this selfish strategy, they reach towards non-cooperative equilibrium, which has profits lower than that at the cooperation solution. At the non-cooperative equilibrium, both firms are jointly producing 1/3 times of monopoly output. Now we will study the prisoner's dilemma game. Here, the non-cooperative equilibrium makes both players worse off than if they were able to cooperate. The problem with the Nash equilibrium is that it does not necessarily lead to Pareto efficient outcomes. Suppose there are two persons, prisoner A and prisoner B, and both have been caught for committing a bank robbery. In order to procure confession from them, they are interrogated separately so that they cannot communicate with each other. The strategic form of the game can be written as players, two players, prisoner A and prisoner B. Strategy, each player can either confess or not confess his crime. Payoff matrix, the payoffs are showing the years of imprisonment. The payoff matrix for this game is given in table. The upper left hand corner of the payoff matrix tells us that if both prisoners confess the crime, both would get an imprisonment of 5 years each. The upper right hand corner tells us that if prisoner A confesses, a prisoner B not confesses, then prisoner A would get 10 years of imprisonment and prisoner B would go free. The lower left hand corner tells us that if prisoner A not confesses and prisoner B confesses, then prisoner A would get no imprisonment and prisoner B would get 10 years of imprisonment. The lower right hand corner tells us that if prisoner A not confesses a crime and prisoner B also not confesses, then both get 8 years of imprisonment each. Here, each prisoner faces an uncertainty regarding how the other person will behave, that is, whether he will confess or not confess. So, each person has to make an independent choice whether to confess or not to confess a crime. Prisoner A reasons as follows. First, if prisoner B confesses a crime and prisoner A also chooses the same, then prisoner A will get 5 years of imprisonment. But if prisoner A chooses not to confess, then prisoner A will get no imprisonment. Thus, the best strategy of players A is not confess a crime. So, person A claimed, my best strategy is not to confess. Secondly, if prisoner B not confesses a crime and prisoner A also chooses the same, then prisoner A will get 8 years of imprisonment. But if prisoner A chooses to confess, then prisoner A will get 10 years of imprisonment. Thus, the best strategy of player B is not confess a crime. So, person B claimed the best strategy again is not to confess. Same reasoning goes for prisoner B. As a result, they both end up by not confessing a crime and getting 8 years of imprisonment. This is the Nash equilibrium. But if they had been able to communicate with each other, they would both have confessed the crime and get 5 years of imprisonment. Once again, the non-cooperative equilibrium makes both prisoners worse off than if they were able to cooperate, that is, if both are making decisions, they end up by not confessing a crime.
Now, let us summarize whatever we have learned. An oligopoly is an industry characterized by few dominant firms. Oligopoly is said to prevail when there are few firms in the market producing or selling a product. Oligopoly is also referred to as competition among the few. When an oligopolistic firm is cooperating with other firms, it gives rise to cooperative solution. But if firms compete with each other, it gives rise to non-cooperative equilibrium. If the firms in an industry cooperate among themselves to produce the monopoly output, then they can maximize their joint profits. The cooperation among firms may be either tacit or formal. A formal cooperation among firms is one when all the firms under oligopolistic industry, after consultation and discussion, agree to observe certain rules of conduct with respect to price, output, etc. This formal cooperation is also known as collusive oligopoly. On the other hand, the tacit cooperation among firms occurs when all the firms under oligopolistic industry, without consultation and discussion, have developed some understanding between them and pursue a uniform policy with regards to price, output, etc. So, if the firms tacitly or formally cooperate, they will reach to a cooperative solution. The non-cooperative equilibrium is an equilibrium that is reached by firms when they proceed by calculating only their own gains without cooperating with others. It is called non-cooperative equilibrium or a Nash equilibrium. In an oligopolistic market, each individual firm is faced with the problem of choosing rational course of action from many possible actions while keeping in view the possible reactions of his rivals whose counter moves would affect him. Game theory analyzes the oligopolistic behavior as a series of strategic moves and reactive counter moves among rival firms. A strategy is a course of action which a player in a game will choose during the play of the game. Players are choosing strategies without knowing with certainty what strategy its rival is going to play. Here it is assumed that firms are anticipating rival reactions. Each player's aim is to maximize their own payoff by choosing specific actions. But the outcome also depends upon what other players are doing. The payoff matrix shows the profit of each player given its decision and the decision of its competitors. We have seen how under the prisoner's dilemma game, the non-cooperative equilibrium makes both players worse off than if they were able to cooperate. The problem with the Nash equilibrium is that it doesn't necessarily lead to Pareto efficient outcomes.